Good girl. Thank you, sweetie. Thank you, sweetie.
Just brought the ashes out. I'm gonna dump them on that log pile. Perfect place. They're out of the way. They're not gonna bother anybody. Not gonna be unsightly. Every winter I bring out the ashes, and you know, this year I thought, well, man, throw them here. And I've been doing that the last couple, two or three times I had empty, but I've got a real concern here. Are there hot embers left in there? You know, I empty it once, the wood stove, every morning into there. Are there leftover embers from the night before? That worries me. Oh, it's warm. not hot. Well, down at the bottom, there's nothing that's hot. So I'm going to throw them on the wood pile. Again. Now you can see all the ashes from there. Good. Throwing any embers on this thing, it would take off in a flash, all the leaves and the kindling. Ooh. On the advice of Jim, the owner of this ATV, it'd be a good idea to get a trickle charger on it over the winter. Just leave it on. It'll keep the battery topped up. And I bought one, 20 bucks on Amazon, plugged it in, hooked it up. There's a little green light. It says power. Green light came on, but that's all. I didn't think anything of it. Good, the power's on. It's doing its thing. Well, then I got to thinking more and more, there should be these other lights should come on, and they weren't. There's nothing there. I began looking around, going online to find out. Somebody asked the same question I was having trouble with. So somebody answered and said, oh, it's a bad unit. Send it back. Well, I'm not going to send it back. But in the package that came with the charger, there is this little plug-in. You hook these onto the battery terminals, and you plug in the charger here. This cap comes off. And then I noticed a fuse holder. I looked in there and there's a fuse. And then I thought, I wonder if the fuse for this thing is blown. Right there. And I looked in there 10 minutes ago. There is no fuse. Oh. So I removed the fuse from this, put it in there, plugged it in. Oh, look at that. Huh. Problem solved. It's not a bad unit. It was a bad fuse. Non-existing. Insley has just flushed 5 partridges along the driveway, south of the driveway. That is partridge land. First one flushed on the right, which she didn't hear. I flushed it, I guess, just being on the driveway. And then we got a little further this way from the house and froomph, froomph, froomph. They didn't sound quite like that, but that's, you get the idea. Wow. And she took off like a shot. This is her playtime. Her kingdom. Her playground. Oh, what fun. I admire her so much. (laughs) And she always comes back fairly soon. Well, I saw her up along the ridge running back and forth. Now she's over there. Oh, she just loves this. And after supper, she always, usually, goes and lays down, flumps down in the entryway, like she wants to go out. Well, she does, obviously. And I used to think it was because she needed to pee or something. No, she wants to come out and do a little hunting before dark. And then she's had her fun time, her merriment. We go back in and she settles down on the love seat. Oh, what a girl. I can't take that little tree down. It's a berry tree of some sort, and I watched it all summer. It's really in the way of the plow. I wanted to wait until berrying season was over, but looking at it now, it's such a cute, sweet little tree. I can't take it out of there. I'll have to work around it. I'm going to leave it. it needs to be left. I will look at it next May when it begins to leaf out and get flowers and be so glad I did not just cut it down.